Good morning. I'm Bakr Al-Azawi, from a PhD student from Cardiff University in United Kingdom. As the chairman said, the presentation title is Mechanical Arm Fracture Performance Properties of Self-Conducting After High Performance Concrete. The presentation contains will be about introduction, experimental work on results, fracture parameters, fatigue performance and results on the conclusion. Cardiff RC is the trade name of two main groups of ultra high performance fiber reinforced concrete, mixes 1 and 2, primarily different primary and maximum size of quartz sand, which is 0.6 mm in mix 1 and 2 mm in mix 2. Cardiff RC mix 2 has been developed to a self-compacting and tested competitive performance concrete. This development provided innovative solutions. One of these solutions is a reduction in the cost and the health hazards by replacing the thin, expensive, glass-coated steel fibers with only 2.5% by volume and cheaper steel fiber 20 mm long and 0.55 mm in diameter. The second solution is the avoidance of health and environmental hazards by creating a self-compacting comp mix not requiring noisy vibration. Now let me talk briefly about experimental work results. The mix proportion of this practical self-compacted concrete version is shown in table 1. A hot curing regime was used for 9 days. There was no acidification or bleeding found during the strong flow test. The mechanical properties of this ultra high performance fiber concrete version of Cardiff RC Mix 2 are detailed in table 2. The size independent fracture energy, G capital F, was measured using the simplified method of Abdullah Al-Kalihalo 2003, as shown here in table 3. And the load deflection curves for 10 and 60 millimeter notches are shown below in table, in table figure, sorry, 2A and 2B. The linear cracked hinge model was using a bilinear stress crack opening relationship, which was proposed by Ellison in 2001, is used in this work. And the load deflection relationships of the beam are established depending on the position of the fictitious crack along the depth of the beam, as you can see in figure 3. The unknown parameters are the bilinear stress crack opening diagram, like W1, W2, FT, sigma 1 over FT, or A1, A2, FT and sigma 1 over FT, are identified in an inverse method manner by minimizing the root mean square error between the recorded and predicted load deflection diagram at many values of the applied central load. And the parameters are for both notches, 10 or 60 millimeter, are tabulated in table 4 and shown in figure 4. The recorded and predicted load deflection curves for notch to depth ratio 0.1 and 0.6 are shown in table in figure 5A and 5B. And the error that was shown in table 4 is obtained by calculating the difference between the measured G small f, which is the size dependent fraction energy, and that given by the area and stress crack opening diagram for each notch depth. The parameter of the tension suffering curves obtained using the linear hinge model corresponding to the measured G small f for 10 and 16 millimeter notches, but not to G couple, which is the size of the manufacturing energy. For the estimation of the binding gap, certain diagram corresponding to the size of the manufacturing energy, G capital F, for complete mix, the simple method that was proposed by Abdullah Al-Kanihadl, 2004, is followed in this work, and the parameters are tabulated in table 5, and shown figure 6, with these parameters that obtained from James Stanford, 10 and 16 millimeter notch. The accuracy of the parameters of the binding and specific coupling relationship relation is provided by predicting the Rossi Amundi plot and comparing it with the equivalent plot. This is done in figure 7 for 1 to 2 notch depth ratio, which is 0.1, and for which it can be concluded that the identified parameter for this notch depth ratio are accurate. Now let me talk briefly about the fatigue performance and results. Fatigue test under tensile loading was conducted on an unnotched 3-point bend strips. The static 3-point flexural strength of these strips was found to be 24.36 MPa. Tests were performed in the sinusoidal load range between 0.6 to 4 kN and 0.6 to 4.5 kN, 0.6 to 5 kN and 0.6 to 5.5 kN, which represents a percentage from the static strength 8.76 as a lower limit to 58.39, 65.69, 72.99 and 80.29. The frequency of the circuit used is 5 Hz, which about 6 hours to complete 1 million in the cycle. The test was stopped after specimen failure or after 1 million cycle, whichever occurred first. The cyclic loss of deflection traces of the specimen were recorded every minute, is that to say, every 300 cycles. All specimens sustained at least one million cycle without failure, as in table 6, although some monitor tracks were noticed at the tension surface of the specimen, some specimens. And it was found that in this limit of this ultra high performance concrete is about 80% of the static tensile strength at a mean stress level of 0.85 MPa, which is 44.5 of its strength. And in the model test, the cycling load had a zero value, which increases as the upper limit increases, which has a marked effect on reducing the fatigue life. The mean stress level for each stress test can be seen in table 7. The complexes of fatigue specimen were calculated from the recorded load deflection traces, and the figures 10 to 13 say the variation in the compliance of the specimen with the number of cycles. It's clear from the figures that the compliance of the ultra-high performance concrete stay for all the range of the 3-point flexural strength is practically unchanged up to 1 million cycle, and the slight increase that seen in the figures is maybe an indication for an internal micro cracking. Now let me talk about the fiber distribution. The distribution of fibers plays a crucial role in the fatigue resistance of ultra-high performance concrete. This was noted from another patch cast earlier, where the instrument was just about 55% of the static tensile strength at an express level of 33.6% of this. The number of cycles that was sustained by each specimen can be seen. Can be seen in figure in table 8, and the examination of the failure surface of the specimen confirmed that the fibers were fully distributed in the mix, and you can see here from the highlighted red. At the end, the conclusion was that a self-compacting ultra-high performance concrete based on counterparts CMX2 was developed and fully capitalized from both mechanical and functional and fatigue point of view. And as expected, the resulting ultra-high performance concrete has inferior compression tensile and structural strength than the original counterparts CMX2. And this is due to the absence of the small, thin brass coated steel fibers for 4.5 by percent by volume and 6 mm long in the ultra high performance concrete. The ultra high performance concrete is, however, much tougher. This is due to the use of larger volume of traction, 2.5%. Against 1.5% of longer steel fibers, 30 mm long against 13 mm. And if there's a approach based on the linear hinge model for uncollectable growth from a pre-existing bridge was used to identify the parameters of the bilinear stress crack opening relation of ultra-high performance concrete. And finally, the uniform distribution of steel fibers ensures that the material has high fatigue endurance strength, about 80% of its static flexural strength at a stress level of about 44.5% of static strength. But this limit reduces significantly to about 55% of the static strength at a stress level of 33.6%. The distribution is non-uniform with the regions of few or no fibers. That's all what I have. And thank you for listening.